Hello everyone, good evening. So today we will see a basic block diagram of communication system or any communication network. Okay, so this is only a basic diagram. Okay, here we will try to know completely and clearly what are the components and what are their functions, so why they are used particularly in the system or channel or this particular diagram. Okay, so first, the communication channel consists of, or the communication system consists of, discrete information source. The first block diagram is discrete information source, then source encoder, channel encoder, modulator, electrical communication channel, then demodulator, channel decoder, source decoder, and destination finally. Okay, so let us try to know what are all the functions of these blocks and why they are here. So first one is discrete information source. That is nothing but our the module which produces the data signal. Okay, the data may be anything like audio, video, or image. It may be anything. Okay, here the data will be produced by the discrete information source. That means the data will be produced at the first block. Okay, then comes the source encoder. Okay, then source encoders, the data will be produced in the form of digital signal 110100. I have taken randomly one signal. Suppose this is our data, we are sending some image. Okay, so that image is converted to data or digital form, because it's nowadays everything is in digital form. Computer understands only digital data, that's why everything is converted to ones and zeros. So what is the use of source encoder? Source encoder creates some, it scrambles the signal. So why this is used is, suppose you are sending in military applications, you are sending some secret information to our soldiers, and if you don't scramble the data, then someone, the enemy receiver also, suppose there are two receivers, okay, one and two. This is our Indian receiver and this is Pak receiver. Okay, so we are sending data to our soldiers, then the signal will reach to this receiver also and this receiver also. If we don't scramble the data, then Indian receiver also decode the signal and Pakistani receiver also decode the signal, and if they knows our message, then it will be serious threat to our national security. So in order to make the information secret or make it not visible to another receiver or unwanted people, it is scrambled. Like one, there will be added two zeros in between, then one, there will be added one double one between zero and one one again, like any sequence is added in between. Okay, so our message data will be here like this. So it is scrambled in way, and the only receiver which know the scrambling pattern or the pattern which is used as the encoder can decode the signal. So Indian receiver will be knowing what is the encoded or scrambled sequence, so it can only decode the signal, and Pakistani or any other enemy country's receiver can't decode the signal because they will be not knowing this scrambled sequence. So it is very difficult for them to decode the signal. Thus, for security purpose, the source encoder used here. So its work is security. Okay, security its work is. Then channel encoder. So now comes channel encoder. Now the question arises, why channel encoder is used? So you are sending some data here. So this is your data. Then for this data, there will be many other data which is attached, like what is the sequence, how much is the sequence length. Basically, the channel encoder's work is to facilitate the demodulation of the signal at the receiver. So there will be appended header bits, and there will be trail bits which will indicate length of the data, and phase and other amplitude, other components will be in the data. And about the source and destination locations of the data are indicated in the are appended to the data. That's why channel encoder is used for the successful or to make the transmission of signal easy in the communication channel and receive it properly at the receiver. So there will be adding destination address, here will be adding source address, will be adding data length, we will be adding, and many other paging, if it is paging system, page length we will be adding. So there are quite lot of bits will be added to the data in the channel encoder technique. So it is for successful or proper transmission of the data in the channel. Then modulator. Okay, so everyone will be knowing the modulator. Modulator is just like a vehicle. So suppose you want to go some village, okay, it is 100 kilometers far away, so you can't go by walk. Okay, so there is your home. Okay, this is your home, so you can't go by walking. Then you will get to the bike or bus or anything which will be acting like a carrier for you. For this will be same for the message signal. So the message signal will be very weak, so it can't reach to the far distance or receiver. So in order to reach to the far receiver, we will be adding a high frequency carrier with whose strength will be more. So by adding with the message, we can cover a larger distance. Okay, so electrical communication channel means it's a electrical wireless or wired medium is there, and of course for that noise will be added together, and this will be this will come to demodulator, and then channel decoder, source decoder and destination, it will reach finally. Thank you. Thanks for watching.